Yeah, well, for teaching at the Tonmeister department here, we focus very much on something that is very broad, but also something that is very personal and very deep if you look at the personal qualifications for each student. So we always say that here you will learn to work with every single type of ensemble, from symphony orchestra to jazz band, rock band, electronica, all styles of music. And you can do that on a professional level, but at the same time you need to find one or maybe two places where you are a super expert. So in one sense we have a broad cooperation across the whole department to do many genres of music, but at the same time we investigate and find where's this very deep personal interest of one specific student, and we nourish that a lot. And that means that students are able to bring in productions from the outside world, you can say, in here. We don't like to talk about school projects, we just talk about music, because it always counts. So students are very much encouraged to involve their own music productions into the academy here. And in general, you can say in the bachelor's program, we have a little bit more of a focus on the broad side, that you get to learn everything. And then it will sort of crossfade, as a word we like to use here, into a more artistic approach where you more nourish your own approach to music production. Yeah, one of the things that we are very fortunate to have here at the Royal Danish Academy of Music is very good production facilities. And that means that our students here, they have a possibility to do a lot of practical work. There's a tendency to say that if you are a musician, you have a lot of things to practice on. You practice scales, you practice different techniques and a big repertoire. But when you are a Tonmeister, how do you actually practice? How does a Tonmeister practice 5 hours a day? And a very important way to practice is basically just to do a lot of musical productions. And since we have a very good amount of recording studios and mixing facilities here, it is very possible for students to get a lot of hands-on experience. And that will match very well to, you can say, we have a layer of lessons here that are very theoretical: acoustics, electronics, theory of digital audio and microphone technology, that are very, very theoretical, could almost be at a technical university. And then we have more practical lessons that will sort of interact the theoretical knowledge into more practical lessons. And then at the same time, there's a third line of student self-practice and self-productions where they can get focused feedback from tutors. But there's sort of this spectrum of layers, and we do the best we can to try to make those three layers of teaching connect as well as possible. Yes, something very new here at the Royal Danish Academy is that we have started working a lot with the 3D audio. And we have just this year, in the autumn of 2019, opened a very big 48-channel loudspeaker system in our new hall. And we actually have in the curriculum for Tonmeister program, we have 3D audio as a scheduled subject. So we have a very, very good laboratory to work with the experiments for 3D audio, but it's not only a laboratory, it is also a chamber music hall. So that means, for instance, next week we have a whole very long 8-hour workshop in the 48-channel dome, but after the workshop we invite an audience in and we make a presentation of our 3D work there. Well, the Royal Danish Academy of Music is a quite special place for Tonmeisters, first of all because we are in the old Danish broadcast radio building, and that means that the facilities we have here, studios and concert halls, are very, very good compared to the size of our school. Then I will say that we also have a very good study environment here. We are usually just around 20 Tonmeister students divided over 5 years, so something around 4 students in every class. And we have a lot of shared activities. We just come now from a common lesson where everyone are there. We meet every week across all years of study. So we have a very good social, social interaction between the students. They are also working on productions across the different years of studying here. And we have, the students here are very good, but they are not competitive in a negative way. We help each other a lot. Out of philosophy to say, well, if we all help each other and share knowledge, we will all become much better, rather than competing, trying to hold the others down. So there's a lot of sharing of knowledge and experiences. And then also we have this special situation that the academy we're at now is primarily for Western classical music, but for Tonmeister department we work with pop, rock, jazz, electronica, folk music, music from various cultures, and also Western, a lot of Western classical music. And we have a very good expertise at our school, also in the faculty, relating to all genres of music. And I would say the philosophy here to say that you learn, even though you will end up as a rock and roll sound engineer, you know your way around a symphony orchestra very well. And that means that you can mix recording and production methods from one genre and bring it into another genre of music, which actually is quite similar to, if you go back to the early 60s, when rock and roll music design really started out. Many engineers back then also had a classical background. So we can learn from each other, even though you specialize in one direction, it gives a great value that you know everything.
Cool. Yeah.